Dale Reynolds Gaming, racing excellence.
In the game.
Hello everybody, Dale Reynolds here, back again with another playthrough, a retro playthrough for you. Some of you guys have known about it for a while. Here we are, the time has come, NASCAR 99, the 20th anniversary playthrough of this game. I thank you for joining me in this one. NASCAR 99 was released on both the N64 and the PlayStation 1 back in 1998. I was 7, and here we are, 20 years later, back again. Doing this. Thank you for joining me. We're gonna get this thing underway doing the championship season playthrough. So getting it kicked off here. So my theory is that I am going to race the driver that won the championship in the year the game came out. We did it with NASCAR 98. It was released in 1997. Jeff Gordon was the champion that year. Guess what? Jeff Gordon was also the champion in 1998. That means I get to race my favorite driver for one more season. Anyways, in these 20th anniversary playthroughs, because we all know Jeff Gordon was like the man in the 90s. So, yeah. So here we go. I'm going to select the car here. And again, thank you guys so much for tuning in and watching. Selecting the car of the number 24 DuPont Chevrolet Monte Carlo at the time, Jeff Gordon. There's my car. There's my driver. Now, here's what we're going to do. I know that this playthrough, the NASCAR 98 playthrough, we didn't qualify. We put it on a full sim mode, doing things a little bit differently here. So we're going to have a pit mode. We're going to have a short race. So this way we at least have to pit once in the race. Race length, 5% damage on yellow flags on, breakdowns on, physics and AI settings. We are going to do... Let's do simulation. We're going to do simulation once again. But this time we're going to actually qualify and, give ourselves a little bit more of a chance. We didn't really give ourselves much of a chance in NASCAR 98. So, yeah, we're going to do that. We're going to give ourselves a little bit more of a chance. Qualify. Still no setups, but we're going to qualify and race, do it the proper way. So, still simulation mode and not arcade mode. Hopefully this goes a lot better than NASCAR 98. And I mean, the Terry Labonte factor and the difficulty that it was. So, everything's done there. Everything should be good to go. Without further ado, let's get this championship season started.
Welcome to an exciting new season.
Bob Jenkins and Benny Parsons.
EA Sports.
Nice.
Hi everyone, I'm Bob Jenkins. Alongside me is racing analyst and NASCAR champion Benny Parsons. NASCAR has seen a number of changes since last season, BP.
Bob, you're absolutely right. We've got some hungry new teams, a talented crop of rookie drivers, and some veterans that have switched teams and are looking to make a good first impression. In addition, we have a whole lot of new sponsors and paint schemes. I can't wait for the green flag to drop.
Well, I certainly agree.
God,
with
I fucking miss Benny Parsons.
Championship season starts with
rest in peace, Benny.
Effort and a strong will to overcome adversity. Benny, what do you see as the key?
Consistency, consistency, consistency. Let's not forget in 1996, Terry Labonte posted only two victories and still won the championship. Remember, the one with the most points wins. Consistent finishes are the key. And a little luck never hurts.
Back when winning a championship meant something. Back when you won a championship from all 36 races. Not some stupid playoffs.
Sega still had the rights to Daytona for the arcade game, so I may or may not be wrong with that. So Daytona's still missing, but we are going to Rockingham. We're going to Rockingham for the first race, and well, without further ado, let's qualify and see where we go. Jerry Mayfield is on the pole with Terry Labonte on the outside front. Oh my god, Terry Labonte's still OP as fuck. Hopefully he's not as OP as he was in NASCAR 98. Oh my goodness. Oh my good, look good. Yeah, good god. Look at these graphics. They are much more refined than NASCAR 98 was, but wow. Downshift. Oh, frame rate just like picked up all of a sudden. Holy crap, that threw me off. And I hit the damn wall. Look at the frame rate just pick up through the center of the corners. That's gonna throw me off. I don't know what kind of a lap that was, but...
Oh, that was a beauty. We got a great starting position.
Okay, I kind of screwed up on that. Where do we end up? Sixth. Okay. I'll take it. Sixth. Better than starting 24th. Better than starting 24th. I'll take it. All right, ladies and gentlemen, race number one of the NASCAR 99 retro playthrough. Starting from the sixth position, Jerry Mayfield is on the pole. Let's go racing for 19 laps here at Rockingham.
Gentlemen, start your engines.
Dale Earnhardt, Jeff Burton make up row two. Rusty Wallace and Jeff Gordon, yours truly, row three. Bobby Labonte and Dale Jarrett, row four. Ernie Irvin and Mark Martin starting inside the top 10. Not even double file restarts. That's
funny. The green flag is out. We're in Rockingham, North Carolina, home of North Carolina Motor Speedway for today's race. Joining me is analyst Benny Parsons. Benny, what can you tell us about the track?
The Rock is known for exciting racing. Its wide surface and high bank turns make for some thrilling moments.
Look at the drafting effect. Holy cow. Like, that was like a nitrous boost in the draft.
The
Marky
Rock
up to third.
The side of the Unocal 76 Rockingham World Pit Crew Competition, which crowns the world's fastest pit crew.
Deep low.
Terry Labonte's taking... Uh-oh. Not this time, Terry Labonte.
He's almost up to the front.
Damn it, Terry Labonte.
Takes a spot away.
He's picking them off one at a time.
Uh-uh. Not this time around, baby. Not this year.
Clear high.
Sorry. OP as fucking NASCAR 98. I am going to do my best to not let that happen.
He should just concentrate on the leaders now.
Well, we're in the lead.
Nowadays, stock cars are adorned with all kinds of sponsor decals, but that wasn't always the case. In the 1940s, numbers were the only graphic on the entire car. The 50s saw the engine's horsepower painted on the hood, and by the 60s, teams began to realize the benefits of sponsors and started slapping decals on their cars.
Terry Labonte is taking the lead from us after a nice little history lesson by Bob Jenkins. Right, the announcers do a lot more talking.
Looks like some contact out there.
I run into the back of Terry Labonte, and I got damage.
Clear high.
Awesome sauce. This is going to be fun. That drafting effect, I can already tell, is going to cost me
these
at some point this season. I can already
and
tell.
Of steel to keep their cars going around
tell.
The racetrack.
I want to change something. I want to do time display. Yes. Turn on that time display. I like that stuff. I like to see where they are. Because this game, I don't believe, has a rear view mirror.
Something appears to be wrong with Rusty Wallace's number two car.
Oh, Jerry Mayfield taking a lead for me. How about that?
Taking over the first position is the Mobile One car.
He might have the strongest car out there today.
Not if I ain't got nothing to say about it. Hey, I hit that turn
pretty good.
Earnhardt
is running third.
He must stay focused. Oh my God, look at that. Oh my God, you see that? Holy shit, on a stick. Yo, drafting is insane in this game.
Rusty Wallace is done for the day.
That car's going behind the wall.
Something appears to be wrong with Ernie Irvin's number 36 car.
Wow, a lot of people. Attrition is really high today, apparently.
Takes the spot away.
Ernie Irvin, Jerry Mayfield. There's going to be a lot of attrition.
Jeff Bodine is making a run with the Phillips car.
Jeff Bodine.
The position shuffle.
My goodness.
Earnhardt is running third.
He's moving up on second place.
I'm starting to figure this out a little bit. This is not a sim, that's for sure. Even though it's in simulation mode,
every driver who qualifies for
not
a
sim.
Race receives points. There are also built-in incentives such as leading a lap, which reward drivers for strong performances. This type of scoring system rewards consistency, which is the key to winning the cup.
Carlo,
I'm scared to get in the draft. I'm legitimately scared to get into the draft. Like,
the driver out front is Jeremy Mayfield.
Jeremy Mayfield,
that car is on a
wait to say Pocono. Oh my God, look at that draft.
Clear high.
I am scared
Ernie
to get
Irvin
into the draft.
Ernie Irvin is done for the day.
Because, my God.
Clear high.
A good little race here up at the front.
Keep low.
Oh, we're about to go three wide. No.
Halfway home. Keep it up.
Keep it up.
Cars on both sides.
The driver out front is Jeremy Mayfield.
Mayfield,
he's driven
contact.
A smart race all day.
Look at this race, though.
Keep low.
Earnhardt is running in second position.
I'm trying so hard not to
it's
run
to the
back.
It's time to find the leader on the track.
I know that I'm going to probably do that at least once in this championship mode.
Jeremy Mayfield is pulling in.
I'm going to draft somebody, and the draft is going to take over, and I'm going to slam the crap out of him. Probably knock myself out the race.
The Interstate Batteries car is in second place. He's driving with a lot of confidence today.
Off the wall, thanks. I am going to pit this time around, and we...
Come on, check your fuel, buddy.
I do believe we have to pit on the backstretch. These old NASCAR games...
You're low on fuel.
Do
Jeff
have us
Gordon
pit on
is
the backstretch.
Jeff Burton is second. The number three spot belongs to Jeff Bodine.
Cut down here.
Moving up through the field is the number eight car of Hutt Strickland.
Right tires, right sides. Let's make that. Let's adjust that wedge too. Screw it. Why not? Let's adjust the wedge. Let's make the car turn a little bit.
They're only changing right side tires. They're making some wedge adjustments.
Oh
we'll
man.
We'll fill her up.
Come on, baby. Let me get out there. Let me go.
Go, buddy. Go.
Damn, I lost the lead.
The number four spot belongs to Jeff Burton.
Damn, I'm at 13.
Jeff Gordon has dropped out of the top 10.
I dropped out of the top 10. Yo, I got
Bobby
past Darrell Walker. What the? Wow, okay.
Sixth place.
Did they not take tires or something? Like, I don't remember.
Seventh place belongs to Bobby Hamilton.
I don't remember if they took
Eighth
tires.
Eighth place belongs to Ricky Rudd.
Okay.
Ninth place belongs to Johnny
adjusted
Benson.
And I'm on
Terry
pressure
Mahoney
right sides. Let's see if this does anything. Okay. I think Mayfield's still leading this thing.
With racing like this, I wish every day was a Sunday.
Damn right, BP. I agree. Rest in peace, Benny Parsons. I fucking miss you.
Passing in a turn can be a tricky proposition. It takes nerves of steel to pull it off. But if you do, your chances of winning a race are very good.
It takes nerves of steel to pass in a corner.
Great action all over the racetrack.
Just running up on the back of these guys with that draft. Holy cow.
Jeff Gordon moves into the top 10.
Hey, we're back in the top 10.
He's steadily charging towards the leader.
Look at us go.
Stay high.
Ooh, I had a turn.
You need to ease up into that corner.
Wow. Okay. Yeah. Well, we're up to ninth.
Marlin is making a run in the number 40 car.
Keep high. Stay low.
Let's see if I can't move.
Keep low.
Damn. These guys definitely didn't take tires.
That's clear high.
That's for sure. I think they just literally topped off the gas and went. Okay.
Stay low.
I thought they might have at least taken tires or something.
Gordon takes a spot away.
Up to six, though. How about that?
Battle for position.
Trying to haul ass. Let's see if I can't catch Bobby Labonte up there for fifth before this thing's over. Damn, I'll have to remember that for the rest of this playthrough. I don't think they take tires.
The number five car of Terry Labonte takes a spot away.
Oh, Terry
Labonte. He's working his way up through the field.
We're catching him. So it's not like we're really off pace. We're actually catching him pretty quick.
North Carolina Speedway is a wide, high bank, 1 mile over. Boy, Bob, you don't see traffic like this on the interstate.
No, you do not. See if I can't catch Bob Labonte here for like a top five or something. Holy cow. That drafting effect is insanity.
Number 12 car.
White flag is out. One lap to go.
Just
here's Rockingham.
One more lap to go.
Can I pick up Jeff Burton for fourth? With the lightning drafting effect down the back straight.
Clear high.
Looks that way. All right, I'll take it. Not bad for the first time playing this game in years.
What an effort by Gordon to finish today's race in the top five.
I'll take that. That's a lot better than how we started at Atlanta, thinking we were going to win, and then Jeff fucking Bodine happened. And Terry Labonte didn't win. So kudos to that. Jerry Mayfield takes the win. As you see the rest of the running order there, I'll let that scroll through. Jerry Mayfield, Dale Earnhardt, Dale Jarrett, yours truly, and Jeff Burton in the top five with Bobby Labonte, Mike Skinner, Bobby Hamilton, Terry Labonte, and Johnny Benson coming home in the top 10. Here are the race results. Jerry Mayfield led the most laps at 9. Dale Earnhardt got 2. We led 6. And Terry Labonte led 2. Ernie Irvin and Rusty Wallace fell out of the race. So that's pretty much it for season standings. Look, Jerry Mayfield leading, Dale Earnhardt, Dale Jarrett again. Us and Dale Jarrett tied for third in points after Rockingham. We did lead laps. Dale Jarrett did not lead any laps. So pretty straightforward. That was just one race, so pretty much standings are what they are after one race. So that was interesting. Nice throwback. Feeling pretty good, man. Feeling pretty good. Fourth place finish on simulation mode. No setups. I'm feeling it. I am. I'm feeling it, man. Just gotta learn to not take tires, I guess, because they didn't take tires. So, awesome. Anyways, that'll wrap it up for the first race of NASCAR 99 Championship season playthrough. My name is Dale Reynolds. I thank you for allowing me to come into your homes on your phones and cell phones, and I thank you for allowing me to come into your lives with your cell phone, your computer, your tablet, whatever it is that you're using, your illegal cable connection, but I won't say anything about that. No. Anyway, thank you very much. We're off to race number 2 in Las Vegas in the next video, so until then, be safe, have fun. I will see you guys on the next NASCAR 99 video. Deuces!